Hello there everyone, welcome to Temporal Paradox 1. My name's Derek. In this tutorial, I'm going to give people a working solution for how to improve the playback quality of HD video while you're trying to edit it with Sony Vegas Movie Studio or Sony Vegas Pro. This is a part two video. The first video was just a face-to-face discussion to the camera where I explained to people exactly why HD video does have a problem while you're trying to edit it. So in summary, big problem is with AVC HD video, which uses the H.264 video codec. All the top video cameras use that format, as do the DSLR cameras. And the problem with H.264 video codec is that basically it's classified as a finishing codec, which means it's great to use to when you've finished editing your project to render to that, and you use that to present your project to the world. However, because it's so highly compressed, it's not a very good codec at all to be using while you're trying to edit something. Because of the fact that it is compressed, when it's playing through Vegas and you're trying to edit it and add lots of things to it, it's got to be decompressed before you even can see it on the screen. And then when you start adding transitions, effects and multiple layers, it's grinding the computer to a halt. There's two basic solutions you can go for. And the one that I'm going to teach in this video is how to create a proxy video. A proxy video is just a carbon copy of an original video. So basically shrinking the file of the video right down very, very small so that it runs very smoothly in Vegas. So the second step to using a proxy video file, or files I should say, is once you've finished editing your project, you then at the very end replace the low quality files back with the original HD, AVC HD video files. And then you render using them, and everything comes out absolutely beautiful. There's tons and tons of different video converting programs out there, but I've been testing them over the last couple of months and found that a lot of them have big bugs in them, very unreliable. But good news is I've found one particular program which is absolutely free, and it does a beautiful, fantastic job, and its name is Super. So that's what I'm going to use. And the other program that we need to use to use proxy files is a program called Rename It. So the links are below in the description, for the download links for these two programs. And when you install Super, just one thing to be aware of, a little window will come up and it will say, would you like to install Driver Cure, something like that. Don't select that, because if you select that option, it installs another program which you need to buy for it to work properly. So just select no on that when it comes to that. When you install Rename It, a little box will come up with a couple of little check boxes. I installed it exactly as it defaulted in the installation process, and it installed just fine. So just install it exactly how it comes up on the screen. Okie dokie, now we can get cracking. First step to do is create a new folder so we have somewhere for our converted video files to live. So my suggestion is go into your master videos folder in your Windows computer, right click, create a new folder, and just call it proxy video and get out of there. Now we've got to boot up Super and get all its settings sorted out. It's a little bit slow in booting up, but don't be too concerned. First thing I'm going to do is click the M at the top, and we're going to tell the program where that folder is that we just created. So click that output file saving management. By default, when you do that, you'll see that little green tick there. Tick that off. then that unlocks the hard drive, so you can then navigate through your computer system, find your videos folder, and then find that new proxy video folder we created. Click on top of that and then press save changes. Next thing to do is tell the program what type of video codec we want to convert into. So on that first drop down box here, open it up, drag the slider up and select MPG, because we're going to convert it into an MPEG file. On the middle selection there, open it up and change it to MPEG-2. On the third selection, open that up and change it to AC3. By default, M encoder should be selected there. For most people on a Vista or Windows 7 computer, I'd say it's a good idea to select Direct Show Decode. This is a bit of a tricky one because it depends on what other programs you already have installed on your computer. Just as a quick, going on a tangent for a quick second, if you own an AVC HD video camera or a DSLR camera, please make sure you install all the software that came with the camera, because often that gives your computer extra codec that your operating system may be missing. And that's where this Direct Show Decode can come in handy. So tick that. Now we've got to select some more settings for the video. On this little section here, click that box there. You'll have to cycle it through. Click it a few times until it looks like that. Change the width to 640 and the height to 360. Aspect ratio, if you're using a widescreen video, which I assume most people would be, select 16:9. Frame rate, choose the frame rate you want to convert your proxy video into. Keep it the same as the HD video clip that you're about to use. So NTSC people 29.97. If you shot it at 24 frames per second, it'd be that one there. If you're a power person, it'd be 25. I'm going to do the NTSC setting just for this example. Bit rate for the video, I reckon about 2016 is pretty good. You can make that higher if you want, but remember, it's all about keeping the file size nice and small. And the final one to check is go right down the bottom, press other options, the O, and I'll just bring that across. Just make sure deinterlace to progressive is selected and that everything down here is all unchecked. Okay, you don't want anything selected there. Then press the O again to get rid of that drop down box. Audio 48,000, that's cool because that's what DVD audio is normally recorded in. Channels 2 because that's stereo. Bit rate for the audio, we can shrink that down to 128, leave that as default, and we're almost ready. So in this little box here, it shows us all the settings we've just set, and all that's left to do now is to right click on this bottom box, go add multimedia files, and navigate through your computer and find where your HD video files are located and select whatever you want to be transcoded. So I'm going to, because you can do batch rendering with this program, I'm going to select 3 videos in one go. Click open, and they're all added down the bottom. You can put as many as you like down the bottom there, and they'll all be converted over one at a time without being joined together. Last thing to do now is just click encode active files. So press that, and it will start to create our new video files, our proxy video files. Now, how long this takes all depends on the speed of your CPU. So if you're on a low-powered laptop, this could take quite some time. It could take anywhere from a minute, 10 minutes to maybe an hour. It just depends on how long, how big your files are. Once you know what the capabilities of your computer are, it might be handy to think ahead and maybe encode this stuff overnight, especially if you've got a lot of work to do, and then you're ready to go the next morning. Or it might only take the time it makes to make a cup of tea to get this done. So when this is finished, I'll come back and be talking to you once again. There we go. There's the beautiful little sound to tell us that everything's been finished. So once that has finished, you can then click this program off. We want to get rid of it altogether. Okay, the next step is to use Rename It. So turn that on. And what this program basically does is it just in a huge big batch, so you don't have to do one video at a time, it helps to rename the file extension. And you'll understand why I do this when we get to the end of this proxy video process. So to set this up, click Rename and select Rename with File Extension. Then select Add Filter, Search and Replace. And in the top box that says Find What, go dot in capitals MPG. Then click the bottom one to clear it out and press OK. Now we can add our video files that we just created, the proxy video files. So click the Add Files button. And that's just a little glitchy thing in the program where just click OK and ignore it. If it picks up a folder that doesn't exist anymore, it has a little freak out. So don't worry too much if that happens to you. It'll only happen to you after you've used this program a couple of times. So navigate through your computer, find where these files are that we just encoded. There we go, there they are. And select them all, press open. Now that's what they're called at the moment. .mts.mpeg, and we want to get rid of the mpeg at the end. And to fix these files up, go across here to the bottom and click Rename Files. And they're done. Click that off. Now we'll go and check to see if that worked properly. So we'll go into the master video folder, find that proxy video files, and there we go. The .mpeg's been got rid of. So we can click that off. Now we can start our Vegas project, just like you normally would. So boot up Vegas, create your new project. Make sure you select Manage Project Files. Very good idea to do. Click OK. Then I'm going to set my project properties doing it this way. Open that up. And I'm going to make a 1080p HD video for YouTube. So I'm going to open that up and find a customized template I've already made. That one there. So this is very important that you set the properties now to match your HD video files, not the proxy ones. Click Apply. OK. Now this is where I do a little tiny trick. I'm going to show you something. First thing I'm going to do is actually save this project with nothing in it. So I'm going to go Project, Save As, Proxy Video Files, yep, and click Save. Then I'm going to turn that off. And I'm going to go back into Videos, and there's Proxy Video. Now, the little tip I'm going to give you here is about file management and thinking ahead. Now, I think it's a good idea to always save your proxy files. They're only very tiny, so it doesn't matter having a few extra files on your computer. But once you do more and more projects, you don't want to have the same name folder sitting here, otherwise it's going to get very confusing. So two suggestions. One suggestion is to say you could create a master proxy folder where you store all your proxies, and you could store them by date or by the name of the project and plonk them all into here. That's one method you could use. But I think an even smarter method to use is to do this, is go across, navigate through your hard drive, find your documents folder, go to the Vegas Movie Studio HD Platinum 10 or 11 projects folder, open it up, and there's our project that we just created. So that's sitting there. Now, drag your proxy videos into here. Then we can open this up. And now, what's I think is a really good idea is that everything related to this project is sitting in the one location on your computer. Now I'm going to turn Vegas Movie Studio back and load up the project. Well, there's nothing there yet, but the name's there. Now we can add in the proxy files. So got to navigate once again to where they are on the computer. So I've shifted them to documents. And select them all. There we go. Drop them into the project. So at this point now, before I start saying that, final step before you get cracking on editing is make sure that your preview window settings are set correctly. You can do it any way you like, but here is another one of my tips. First thing, right click on top of the preview monitor. Select simulate device aspect ratio, very important. But turn off scale video, because when you do scale video, and it's only a low quality video, it'll keep filling up the frame for how much space you give it, which means it's making the video screen get blurrier and blurrier. So what I like to do is turn scale video off and set my screen size manually in here. So because it's a full 1080p project, I select good quarter size, and that makes everything here stay really nice and sharp. Now you can do your project. Spend hours and days doing your project, add your text, do your transitions, add everything that you would in a normal project, right up into the point that you're ready to render. And once you've reached that point, that's when you have to do the final step. So what I do is this. I go into project, save the file again, and I'll rename it and just call this, so this is like a slightly different version of the project, and call this the proxy version in case I want to go back in here and do editing later on. So I click save. Then I turn Vegas off. Now here's one of the tricky things you've got to do. Go into my documents. Find your Vegas project folder. Find the proxy video file folder where the videos are. Actually, go back one step. Yeah. Find where those proxy videos are and rename this folder, because it's gonna trick Vegas. So I'm going to rename it and add at the end of it, I'll call them old, because I've already used them now. Then turn that off. Open Vegas back up. It seems like a lot of steps, but it will make sense once you've done it a few times. It'll be second nature. Click proxy video files proxy. And this is what Vegas is going to do. It's going to spit the dummy. It'll say the following file could not be found in the specified location, referring to the very first video that needs to be imported. So go down to specify a new location or replacement file. Select that, press OK. And now, instead of loading up the proxy files, we're going to find the original HD files. So navigate through the computer once again and go back to the source videos straight off the camera. Find, now make sure you made note of which video that was referring to. Very important to match the exact same video. So select that, click open, and then if everything's working correctly, you'll get this magical screen open up. And it says, do you want to use this location to replace the video? Don't say yes, say yes to all, and it will automatically apply it to every video in your project. Now, if I click on top of one of these videos and look down here, you'll see that now we have the HD videos in the project. Okay. And all it's left to do now is render. So go project, render as, select your template and render exactly how you normally would. And the final thing of all is go project, save as. This time, I'm telling Vegas to save it as the HD version, just so that this version refers to the HD files. So in my computer now, I have two Vegas projects that are identical, except one points to the proxy files, one points to the HD files. Okay, now if something happened and you needed to get back into those proxy files, then the only way you can do it is to go into your videos, find the folder where those where your source video clips are, the HD versions, and change the name of the folder just temporarily. So, you know, I'm just going to go -1. I'm just going to shrink that down. I won't have to get rid of it. Then boot up Vegas and see how we've got two options here. Proxy version, HD version. Click proxy. And it's going to say I can't find the file because we actually renamed it. So you select that. Click OK. And see, this is where, when because I moved the proxy files into the project, it makes it a lot easier. Pull them up and go yes to all. And then you can re-edit using those proxy files. Just remember to then, if you need to, quickly go back in and just rename the HD folder back to its original format. Okay. And that's it. That's how you edit using proxy files, which is going to make your screen work absolutely beautiful, or it should. And then right at the end, you replace it with the original video files. The alternative method to this is for people with fast computers, heaps of hard drive space, and extra money, because it actually, instead of creating a proxy file which is low quality, you actually convert your AVC HD video into an even higher grade video codec, which because it's non-compressed, it plays back beautifully in Vegas, but also actually has a better quality. And the particular codec I'm talking about is Cineform, but I'm going to save that for a separate tutorial at some point in the future. Hope that was helpful. I know it was a lot to get through. Just watch the tutorial a couple of times, you know, especially the part where I talk about what to do, and I'm sure you'll get it. It definitely is worth it in the long run if you are on a slower computer, something like a laptop. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.